What's going on, guys? So welcome to probably the first video in like what's going to be a series that we're going to be doing on YouTube now. So like I was saying, all the content is coming over to YouTube, and what I'm going to be doing is kind of just like documenting the off-season prep, that kind of thing, and just making it into a little bit more of like a story as opposed to just training sessions. So obviously I'll be documenting my kind of stuff on my YouTube. Anna's going to document hers, yeah, over on her YouTube. So we'll have all that rolling again now you're finished with uni.
Yep, thank God.
So yeah, we can get all that going again. But for the first session that we just thought, or for the first video, first day, we just thought we'd get in, give you guys a little bit of an instruction as to what we're going to be doing. I suppose after the session we could have a little bit of a chat about what we've kind of been going on so far with the off-season, plans for next year, that kind of thing. We've got Jay in today, we're in the grow room down in Bristol, just because we're visiting Han's family, and to be honest it's the best gym in the area, so training out of here for this week. We've got a push session today, which for me, a couple of the movements in here are going to be new in terms of like the machines themselves, so it's probably just going to be more about going to failure with the movements themselves. Hannah is on a D-load.
Yeah, so I'll be doing one working set. Just because this week I've been feeling really off, my appetite's gone down, my sleep's been awful. So Cooper's advice, D-load, but not taking things to absolute failure. Just reducing the volume a bit more, just so my muscles can recover. And then be back on it by Monday, hopefully. So
yeah, for the two videos we've got with Jay this weekend, you're going to be D-loading.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean we're going to kind of like skimp on the intensity.
Yeah.
Still going to make it work hard, obviously. but we kind of, because we're in here as well, we're kind of going to merge our sessions together. So we've got pretty similar sessions because Hannah's on a push pull leg split as well. So
yours is just a lot more chest focused.
Yeah.
A lot more delt focused.
There's a couple of things are going to switch up in it.
Yeah.
So like whilst Hannah's doing a shoulder press, so to speak, I'm gonna do like a slight incline dumbbell press. So we'll kind of go through the changes that we're making and whatnot. But as we do with every session, we're gonna start with a little 5 minute walk, get our head in the game, logbooks written up, that kind of thing, and just get going.
Change of session.
I'm not just a bodybuilder, mate. I'm not just a bodybuilder.
Go, 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 go,
Trying to gauge all the kit, man.
I can't do that one. Can't do that one.
It's not a bad problem.
Collecting dust, mate. You're getting the first run out today. Seven and a half kilos up, mate.
Go on.
7.5 kilos.
I thought you had 69 last time.
Yeah. No, no. I got 60s last time.
Oh, good.
60s for seven, and that was 67s for.
Tweaking, tweaking. 61 M way speeding. LV hat backpack.
Deload last week, did we? Did we
win? Did you win?
to sit and chill, like, do my weights for me.
It's a running theme, all the women do all the work and the men just sit there.
We're just slow, mate, that's all it is.
You are?
They're efficient, we're slow. On deck? Yes, man. One. Rinse it, rinse it. There you go.
It's too ambitious, that.
Subliminal thoughts, yeah. Stop spinning, the women are pouring west. Spinning
get all the tension taken away from the belt, so by strapping to your side ring, really helpful.
To the rest of my body, and one area that is quite stands out for me is my delts. So I actually have done one extra delt exercise today just to jump in with the sessions. But normally my delt volume is super low and my arm volume is super high, just for this block anyway. I'm just trying to bring my arms up. But yeah, this is one of the movements where we just differ slightly. So get most of the sessions in together, and then movements we differ, we just sort of like verge off into our own bits.
Again, I use these strength shot wrist straps, because when you're doing cuff movements, you want it under your elbow, you don't want your wrist to be taken over, so this stops it from slipping down.
Yeah. day, mate. You got a bit bored.
Yeah, it's hard to stay doing just your one working set on a deload, but yeah, it's for the benefit in the long run, so you have to stick to your guns and not be carried away. But
she wanted to do an extra set on everything. I was like, no, no. But yeah, it's a good session. Like I said, a lot of these, we've not used these pieces of kit before, yeah, so as much as the movements are the same, it's like, even if the machine's a different brand, your logbook kind of doesn't even matter because of the, like, just the resistances and the strength curves and that kind of thing. Yeah. So the goal is just to take it to failure, get the most out of the session, which I think we did.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Same thing again tomorrow with Paul, so Jason come down again from a pull session. But kind of what I wanted to do now, obviously, to like introduce this series, which all three of us had a chat sort of mid-session, and we decided we're gonna call a kind of like series and a journey all in, simply because over the past sort of couple of months, I feel like both of us have kind of gone all in with literally everything to do with bodybuilding and to do with coaching. You know, I've completely just upped and left like my hometown and my family, that kind of thing, yeah, to kind of pursue, obviously, being with Hannah, the bodybuilding side of things, the coaching side of things, moved to an area which is just a lot more central to the bodybuilding community, I feel like it is anyway. Yeah. And the coaching side of things, we've just been investing a lot into this kind of thing with websites, content, that kind of thing, and just kind of not even doubling down but tripling down on everything to do with this, which is why I feel like All In is a pretty relevant, yeah, it's a fitting name. So that's what we're going to go with. This is going to essentially be episode one of All In, which is pretty exciting. It's going to be a long one because we don't actually plan on competing until
late next year.
So it's going to be a long one. We've got a big off season, and then hopefully, if we've built enough muscle, we'll be able to prep.
Like 4,000
calories. Yeah, we'll be able to. We'll be able to get on stage the end of next year, hopefully. But yeah, thank you, obviously, for watching, guys. We are going to just again go all in on the content with this kind of thing, and just try and make sure that we're hammering as much out as possible. We're just going to be as real as possible with it as well. Like, not going to try and glam it up or anything like that. It's kind of not what we do. It's what we spoke about, innit? We wanted this kind of thing to just be real because we're not very good at vlogging and things like that. We're just not very good at it. We're, it's hard to, I find it so hard to be faker.
Yeah, if I can't like not be real that.
Yeah. So. If something's going shit, like, we just accept that it's going shit and you kind of just get through it. There's no glamming it up. There's no mollycoddling the situation or each other. We kind of just, make sure that it's as real as possible. So that's what obviously we want to show you guys on Instagram, on YouTube, that kind of thing. But yeah, like I said, thanks for watching, and I guess we'll see you in the next one.
See you soon.